A deck and B the B deck. C deck and B the B deck to get my bomb, right? But that's not any of the results that we got.
Dude, check out my
so obviously there's something happening with the data that's being hit through the lock domain that the lock doesn't know what to do. What I want to do now is actually start to break down every segment, put it in a branch with the same exact number. So I want to create two trees, right? Each one has the same exact number of branches, and each branch has the same index, identification number, and then the lock will try to match them. Remember from any of the other manipulation, which one does this? Which one that I give it a tree, and then it will give me branch for every single data. Right. So now if I take, get rid of that law, and now before even the merge, I'll also remove the merge, I'll use it later. You know how you guys remove the hit control? You guys do that? No? Okay. So you know you put shift to add multiple ones to the same thing, right? Like if I want to connect, like let's say all of them, so if I connect this, what happens is just going to remove the top one. If I want to connect the top one with the shift, and I will do that for the new one.
Do what?
But if I want to remove particular
control
link or particular connection, I hit control and get it back to the original location.
Mm-hmm. Then I go towards connecting. Right, towards connecting.
Now I have this link, but it's good to know that you can drag back, and you can also, if I have this here, you can also right click and say disconnect, direct to the now, what I'm going to do is actually create a grasshopper, and take all the edges from the first one, all the edges from the second one, and let's see what this process that tree looks like. So let's get a couple of these.
Dude, it's crushing my
computer. Let's just do it the ones that are doing the same thing. So basically, this is what the data looks like. It's a series of curves, each one in one frame. So that's why the lock command just puts them on each way to connect A1 to A1. And then but if I copy this to the graph version, now each one of these lines is an own branch. If I connect the viewer one frame, because all of them are one cluster. If I graph them, this will turn into three or four branches, and each branch we have our orange, inside our orange we have our lines. And each one now has its own unique view, like any unique identification. So we have the viewer, three, the viewer branch, the first branch, the second branch, the third branch. So by doing that, let's see what can happen if I try to lock into the but before doing that, I will still want to merge. So I will merge now with a new graph with data. And now you'll notice what happened. It started taking. It started to match. Now it created for me a tree that had four branches. Every branch starts to get the zeroth item from the first surface, the zeroth item, and put them together. If you see now the numbers, when you actually start adding dimensions of numbers, you see the coordinates of the points are actually matching together. And now if I lock between these, hopefully we get what we want. So again, what happened is that my problem is that I had two surfaces. I didn't start with two surfaces. This is the original component. So it gave me edges, vertices, and surfaces. All what I want to do is to lock between every edge so that it's corresponding edge. The data tree, as it is coming from the deconstruct component, was just one tree, right here, was just one tree with one trunk and all the curves in one cluster, in one branch, similar to the Brussels sprout. So when I give two Brussels sprouts plants to the lock command, what I want to do is just try to connect all of them together randomly. So it gives me that from before that we had before.
Okay, cool.
But again, now I'm happy with the Brussels sprouts. I love Brussels sprouts. I will use it sometimes. But now, for this certain condition, I want extra fruit on an orange tree. With branches and orange at the end, and each orange has one segment, same number, the same size, that can match together in the long time, and you don't even know what to do. Now we start to look, oh, here is the segment number 80, L of number 00000, and then 001. So take the 00 item from the first one, and match the new. As long as your data tree structure matches your final command, whether block or sweep or whatever command you create, the geometry will understand what to do with it. Is that clear or no? Very complicated, right? No, it's not. So first, the
Are you live streaming? The world, dude.
Okay, so
the world.
Okay, the big bank here. So now what else we can do? Let's see what we need here. We drafted them, we merged them, and then we okay, we've been closed. So before the merge, I can take all these before the law. Now let's see what happened. This last tree, the merge one, looks like this. I'll have to say that I'm going to